Thank you.
My name is Ramon Esparza. I'm 44 years old. I'm from Blue Island, Illinois.
Hey, what's good, boy?
How you doing, man?
Everything's good.
Wonderful. Let's get it.
Ready to rock?
I am, man.
When I look down at my leg, it's hideous. It's filled like a balloon. It's just awful.
So warm up, usual.
In 2017, I was about 600 pounds. When I finally found the drive and the ability to be persistent and to pursue what I needed, I started losing weight and I shed about 310 pounds. However, my leg just kept getting bigger and bigger.
When's the last time you worked legs?
That's a tough one, because like, every time I'm on these things, they're monstrous and they hurt.
Right.
My right leg has extreme pain in it. Every time I take a step, it's like lightning.
Yeah.
Through my toes, through my ankle, into my shin, straight into my hip. I mean, it's like fire.
Yeah.
And it hurts. And it hurts emotionally too, because I have to live with this.
Sorry to hear that, man.
The side of the disease you don't see is the mental side, the anguish, the emotional side of it. It's awful. I mean, I can't tell you how many days that I sat in my house not wanting to leave.
So I wear a series of compression garments that keep my leg intact, but I have all of this extra on top, and it just keeps going. It's tough. Like, I'm on these things all day long, and I can't help it. I have to get around, I have to go shopping, I have to do things. And this is what I have to deal with, all of this weight, all of this uncontrollable cottage cheese. It's just there. It won't go away. I used to get mad at this. I remember holding this and crying and telling myself, what is wrong with you?
My life sucked, and I pretended like everything was all right. I was hurting so bad inside. I was lost. I was absolutely lost. There was no coming back.
So I'm dealing with all of this all day long. Wow. And I did that for so long until it got so out of control that it's become what you've seen today.
I have a patient today coming in. His name is Ramon. And he has a really big lymphedema issue. Lymphedema basically means that your lymphatic system is compromised. Your bodily fluid settles in your limbs. It doesn't have the functionality to dissipate back into where it's supposed to be. And so it just causes you to have a really, really swollen limbs. I can't wait to get to see how I can help him out. Well, hello, Ramon.
Hey, Doc, how are
you? How are you?
Everything's good.
Nice to meet you.
It's nice to be met.
How are you doing?
Pretty good.
So let me have the story. Like, how did you get to this point?
So for a long time, I was extremely overweight, and I could not shed the pounds. I started to feel fluid filling in my legs, just swelling in the lower part of me.
How does it feel today?
There's a burning sensation. I mean, sometimes, like, all the way down to my feet feel like when I'm walking, I can't really feel my toes all the time. Even though there's sensation in my toes, they hurt inside my shoes. The one thing I can say about my lymphedema is my feet are spared from the lymphedema, but not from the pain.
Like not that, from the pain. It, well, they're holding constant. A lot of the weight.
Yeah.
That's pretty much what happens to our feet. They hold all of our weight. So let me go ahead and take a look at you, and then we'll figure out what we can do, okay?
Okay.
As a podiatrist, we can treat soft tissue from the knee down, even if it's just the leg. As lymphedema cases go, they don't get much worse than Ramon. Just back up here for me real quick. Ramon's case is one of the worst cases of lymphedema I've ever seen. It's amazing that the feet are spared in all of this.
Big time.
Ramon's feet don't really have the classic lymphedema that you would normally see, but he will have foot problems because of this. All the added weight on his foot, it could cause like a fracture or a break. So when you wear your compression garments, it's kind of holds it up a little bit.
I mean, a lot. Like, I couldn't even tell you what that weighs. I have no
clue. I'm lifting it now, and I can tell you it weighs quite quite a bit. Ramon's legs, they felt like a balloon filled with pudding, only a harder texture of pudding. Let's see how you walk. I want to have you come out in the hallway so we can see how you're standing and walking for now. Okay, that's come fine. On. So Ramon, you're just gonna do like up, back.
Am I sprinting?
No. Walk slowly, like, we'll just walk normally.
Like a pimp walk?
Like a pimp walk?
That's my normal walk.
You want, that's your pimp walk? You do a little gangster lane with your walk?
Yeah, you know what's up. My phone with the payphone.
Let's try normal for now. It's a little bit more heavy, like on the right.
I mean, it swings, especially with no garments, no support whatsoever.
Imagine just every step, you're just kind of like lugging your legs, like everywhere.
It really is a strain on my knee. Mm-hmm. Like, it's awful. Like, it just feels so bad.
When your gait is that abnormal, it will definitely affect your knees. But then moreover, he's gonna develop arthritis in his hips. Like, your hips are not designed to walk with a pendulum, like a swing. It is now time for your treatment.
Okay,
all right.
Let's do this.
Before we start the treatment though, I'm gonna measure your leg, and then I'm gonna measure it again after the treatment. So that way we can see what the difference is in size.
This is like
70 centimeters.
All right.
I'm gonna start him on the FlexiTouch sequential compression device. Mm-hmm. It starts at his toes and it provides compression in segments all the way from his toes to his thigh. So what that does is essentially like training the lymphatic system to actually be stimulated and to draw the fluid back to where it needs to be.
You ready to go?
I mean, I was born ready.
Let's do it.
How's it feel right now?
Like, this is amazing.
Yeah, like feels good, right? Like a little massage.
I would say it feels better than good.
Ah, yeah. Good. Well, good. Well, hopefully it means you'll do it every day. It's gonna take about half an hour.
Okay.
All right, I'm gonna let you be for half an hour.
30 minutes.
All right, so how do you feel?
I feel really good.
Really good?
Yeah, I mean, I want to see what it looks like.
Okay. So before, this ankle was measuring 70 centimeters. So we're going to see how we did. Come on in. All right. So we're at 59. That's really good already. Really good. This is something that will be a battle for Ramon for the rest of his life. There is no cure, but it can be controlled and contained a lot better. He's gonna start to use the compression device every single day for about 6 months.
I promise I will make this commitment to myself. If you say a half hour a day, I'll do a half hour. I need my body back.
This is gonna work. I'm very hopeful. We hope that with the lymphatic therapy that the legs can get smaller and smaller. And so over time, there will be less and less to manage with his lymphedema. We're gonna be consistent.
Yeah.
And then we're gonna reconvene in a couple months.
I'm excited about this. I mean, like, this is huge. This is changing my life.
I think you're gonna do great. Well, hi.
Hey, Don.
I'm good. How are you?
Splendid.
Splendid. That's good. How are your legs? What's going on? Tell me about what's going on.
So here I am in bed.
Okay.
And my right leg, of course, you know, much bigger than the left leg, but a lot more flexible, like a lot more action here.
So, I mean, the plan is for you to continue with what you're doing, because you're doing really well at it. And at some point, we can start to discuss your surgical options. So Ramon has still a bit of fluid that needs to be drained. And then once that gets completed, Ramon's going to come back for surgery to make the skin folds a little bit more cosmetic. So that will come in due time.
Okay, sounds great.
All righty, take care.